Welcome, friends. It is I, Rostov Scarf, and it's time for the vlog. I know it's a bit late. There's reasons for that, and there's reasons for why this vlog is what it is. So let's talk about Smite really quick. Background, I think, is a Hercules Arena. Interesting game there. Let's talk about Smite for a little. Conquest has not been fun the last couple months. It's really regrettable, but it just hasn't been fun. Even when you do three-man conks, you'll get like a duo that's just a pair of jackasses that just doesn't make it fun. So every game I've had in Conquest has had rage quits, has had a DC, has had someone just flip out at the rest of the team. Just nothing good going. It's just been dismal play for like the last couple months. And I get those one or two rare gems that you actually get to see in the games that we do show. And it's just really disappointing. I'm not having very much fun with Conquest. The other day we go in, it's my first game of the day, and somebody quits at 2 minutes in. That was not a good start to that day. Next game, get a rager. Next game, we get a guy just flipping out. Every game, Conquest, just no fun. Nothing fun. Even with three-mans, you get like a duo that's just a pair of jackasses, like I said already. I can't win. Like, I cannot get a team that refuses to be stupid. I don't know how I can get on the other team, because the other team doesn't seem to have that problem. I don't understand. Every team I'm on, there's someone flipping out, someone raging out. Just, what the hell? I've even got intentional feeders. Intentional feeders really suck the fun out of a game. 4v5, you can at least try to fight if you think you're doing all right. But intentional feeder really sucks the fun out of the game. I don't understand how someone could come in there and want to ruin the game for 9 other people. Because even if the intentional feeder is on the other team, it's just really disappointing. Like, there's no fun to it. I really don't see any fun to an intentional feeder at all. And I don't like that at all. I've had 2 intentional feeders in 2 days. How many I had in the last 2 years? 1. I've only seen 1 in the last 2 years. I saw 2 in the last two days. Not last 2 days, but in the last week, 2 days straight, I saw intentional feeders. That is not good. Not good at all. And it just worries me and disappoints me with Conquest. It really does. And just the game in general also worries me. There's a reason why Conquest is the 3rd most popular mode now. That wasn't the case. Conquest was number 1 most popular for a year and like a half. It was number 1 forever. And now it's been dethroned by Assault. And then Arena. Arena's number 2, Assault is number 1. I think that's because those are more chill, less ragey. People are just tired of getting raged at. They're just tired of all that stuff. The thing about Conquest is Conquest is where you get to see the best strategy and stuff like that. At the pro level, you get to see some very entertaining games. But when you play it yourself, you do not get that because there is just some bad people in the community. Now look, it only takes 1 out of 10 people to make it bad. This is the thing. I think your community is not bad at all, but all we need is 1 toxic person to screw it up, and it happens every freaking game for the most part. 1 out of 10 games. 1 out of 10 players. There's going to be at least 1 rager in there that ruins the game for everybody. 1 out of 10 games is when I finally get a game worth showing on for Conquest. Arena doesn't have this problem. Assault doesn't have this problem as much. They still haven't, but not as much. Conquest is the one that really has this problem. And it's just not that fun. So I don't know. Like, I barely got 1 this week. That's it. Next week, I don't know how many we're going to get, but Conquest is going to become less and less if I can't get anything out of them. I dedicated 12 hours to getting just that 1 Conquest game. The rest of it was just really disappointing. I tried to keep my energy up, and it just was a punch in the gut every time. So I don't know what to do, guys and gals. I don't know. I keep going in there. I keep putting my heart out there. I play to the best of my ability every game. You see that freaking 25-whatever game with Thanatos, I do that often. It happens way too often, where I am putting it all in there. So it's really frustrating. Arena, I put it all in there as well, but you get less frustrating people on those, for sure. And Assault, it happens sometimes where there's people who just flip out, but it's very rare, honestly. Assault's the rarest one to get it to happen. Maybe I'll just take a look at, I still gotta get the 10 preliminary games so I can get the ranked bonus. So I might do that with Curse Chat and all that stuff, but those are a different beast. I can't explain the game if I'm talking to my teammates, so I don't know. Maybe I'll show 1 of those. I don't know. That there's not as much merit to those. You get to show how a team can interact together if they're willing to use Curse Chat. But I can't really talk to the audience and explain what's going on in the game if that's what's happening. Another note is I gotta try to look at builds more often. It's really hard to do that. Like, I can look at a build really quick and be alright, but explaining it while looking at it is less easy to do, so I have to work on doing that for the viewer's benefit. That's gonna take some work, but we'll definitely see me do it at the end of games to look at builds for sure. But during games, I gotta work on doing that. I've died looking at builds before, though. Like, trying to get in the groove of it? You gotta work on that, so just gotta work on it. But I don't want us to have less conquest, but right now, we're looking like one this week. Next week, we'll see how many we get. Maybe I'll get luckier. Try to do more three-mans, and maybe it'll be alright, but I don't know. Even with three-mans, you get some bad stuff. And then you can do five-mans, but I fought too many pros in five-man pre-made. They just run us over, and we go, well, that was fun, but I can't really... There's no merit here to show, besides, well, this is how you get trashed. But we've already done that, so I don't know. Apparently, there's some noob teams in five-man pre-made, but I think we're the noob team. We don't actually find the other noob teams. But, yeah, that's all the Smite stuff. So, what is the rest of this thing? This is going to be... We're doing the top 20 list. We didn't do a full-on top 10 video list. So, just top 20. Before I say number 1, it'll be honorable mentions. Maybe before I say top 5 honorable mentions. Just go from the bottom. So, number 20 is Ethan Carter. Now, if you see the... Like, there's all these things. This list is everything we played this year. Doesn't mean it came out this year, but we played it this year. That's what it's about, okay? 2014, we played it. Ethan Carter's number 20. Ethan Carter is the most beautiful game I've ever seen. You think it'd be higher because of that, but I should explain this. Me and Jinx did a bunch of testing of my opinions on a bunch of games, a lot of psychological testing, a lot of game choice, we just tested for hours for this top 20 list, for my opinion of the top 20 list. So there's a lot of randomness that went into this thing to decide what my top 20 was. So here it is now. So then Ethan Carter, like I said, most beautiful game I've ever seen. Amazing, really good, well-crafted, nice presentation, good story. And you gotta see that LP. There's no way around it. You gotta see that. It's just, if you can't play it yourself, watch the LP. It is something worth experiencing. That was a heck of a game. Well done to the makers of that game. Number 19, though, is very recent. That is Fall of Cybertron. That game was balls to the walls, awesomely fun. Being Grimlock was the best part. Me, Grimlock, me, awesome. That was just great. But there were some points to it. They're like, eh, like some part. There were some lulls to it, unfortunately. Things have slowed it down a bit. One thing that I didn't like is I'm Optimus. I want to be badass, but I'm just getting destroyed. Once you get upgrades, you can be awesome with everyone you play. But I didn't have the upgrades yet, so Optimus just kind of just died easily and horribly. While in my understanding, the original Optimus was OP, so it's too bad. Number 18 is XCOM Enemy Within. Now, this is a stream game, so those are not so easy to see. I don't even know if we saved any of the stream games. This was our Sunday night game. We named the units after players, and maybe they'll get killed, maybe they don't. Some people died, some people didn't. I think Ninja died the most. I think he died 3 times, or was it Chin? I know in one of the runs, Chin died a lot. But people die, they get killed, viewers get killed. But we had a pretty fun run in that one. And in the end, Jinx Optimus primed on that one. And it's just a lot of fun, and we're going to probably do the Long War in the future. Now, my understanding is the Long War is incredibly hard, so we're going to be losing a lot, but we're going to have a lot of dead viewers in the future. But it should be fun. Number 17, Divinity Original Sin. Now, this is something that, did I say it was something we played in channel or something we just played in general? I don't even think we did a one-shot. Did we do a one-shot on Original Sin? I can't remember, but it's everything I've played. We didn't necessarily have to have videos on it. I think I said we had videos on it. Not exactly. Divinity Original Sin is a game me and Jinx have played together. It's a really fun co-op RPG. It's just really good. It's a lot of fun to play that game, a lot of choices to go through. And just the way that you and your partner can have different opinions, and then you have to kind of fight it out to decide who has the overriding opinion, which is pretty cool there. A lot of quests going on, a lot of interesting story going on. It's just a really fun game, and it's just fun. I really like it a lot. It's really good with someone else. It's probably still fun alone, but it's a lot more fun with another person. Number 16 is Transistor, and we do have an LP of that one. Check that one out. That game is crazy. Friggin' A. If you really like Bastion, Transistor is not exactly Bastion, but it is something around that cloth as well, and it's pretty good. The combat system is very different, very interesting. A really cool idea was that combat system. The story itself was nice, and I just had a lot of fun with it. It was really riveting from start to finish. Just enjoyed that a lot. Now we're breaking into number 15. That is Valkyria Chronicles. We haven't actually finished it on stream, but we've been playing it in stream. I think we're pretty close to the end of this game. The story's interesting, the characters are really great, I really like the characters. The gameplay is, it has its issues, and it's also pretty cool. It's a very interesting idea. It's like, it's kind of like Fire Emblem, and then a mix of other ideas going on there. And it's pretty good. I like it a lot. There are things that, like, it's Fire Emblem in the characterization, like, the way the game's broken up with the stories and the cutscenes and everything. There's a lot of story in this game, there's a lot of gameplay as well. The gameplay maps are about an hour long each, and they're pretty fun. It's just great to play it. I liked it a lot. And we'll finish it soon enough. Once the holidays are over, we can get back to finishing it. Number 14 is Sniper Elite 3, and it's hard not to put Sniper Elite 3 somewhere on this list, because that is a fun game. And in two players, it's a funner game. Like, it's just fun sniping things. And it's even more fun sniping things with someone else. It's a really fun game. I'm just enjoying it a lot. And they made a lot of improvements from 2. Like, it's visually better, and then just more weaponry going on, and then you got loadouts, and just the whole hide-and-seek kind of system going on there. It's a lot better than 2, and 2 was a great game, which was a lot better than 1, which was also a great game. 1, 2, and 3, all great games. Really enjoy Sniper Elite. So number 13 is Massive Chalice. We've done a one-shot on it so far. This game is in early access, but it's pretty complete already. Enjoyed it a lot, and when it hits release, we may play this again. I'm thinking it might be a Sunday night strategy stream, for sure. I don't know if it'll be an LP, but definitely a stream LP for sure, not a video LP. I just really enjoy Massive Chalice. It is a lot of fun. The only thing missing is you can't name units after players, because, well, you go through them kind of quick, and there's a mix of eugenics and Fire Emblem and XCOM and a lot of things going on there. And it's just a lot of fun. It really is awesome. I really, really love this game. If you like XCOM, you might like it. It's not exactly XCOM, but something around that way. And we do have a one-shot video on that to check out if you haven't seen it yet. Number 12 is Blood Dragon. Blood Dragon is balls-to-walls awesome fun. Really, really fun. I love bow and arrowing everything, though. That was just way too fun. One hit, one kill with those things. It's just a great DLC expansion kind of thing. Not expansion, but it's a great standalone DLC. This is an example of how to do it. It just took the Far Cry engine, took the map or whatever, just made their own version of it, and it was great. It was awesome. Very fun. The finale of that is just amazing. The whole game is amazing. I had way too much fun playing this, and we do have an LP of that as well. And just, oh my god, just too much fun. Too much fun. And that's number 12. Number 11 is Bravely Default. Bravely Default doesn't get in the top 10 for reasons, and that is, the first half of this game is one of the best crafted games I've ever played. The first half of this game is amazing. It's really good. Great story. I was just deep in it. Gameplay's solid. Very fun idea with its combat system. I really liked the game, and also just made grinding just better. It did grinding way better than other RPGs. Second half of the game kind of falls apart, and I don't want to go into much detail on that, but it just does, and because of that, it doesn't make it. But number 10, oh my god, here you go, top 10. Number 10 is Metro Last Light. I've played and beaten this game so many times this year, so many times, and we did an LP on it. And you better have seen that LP. That was a lot of fun doing that LP. Being the Astaska guy, going Metro Last Light, we scripted so much of that game. We spent so much time on that game, making those jokes. I had so much fun making that. Jinx had so much fun making it. It was just way too fun. The game itself, even with all the things we did with it, is a great game. Amazing atmosphere, great lighting. Everything just feels so dark and kind of scary and very depressing, but not in a, like, a horrible way. Well, it is horrible, but it just feels right. The game has some amazing atmosphere. It has some of the best atmosphere I've ever experienced in a game. The only game that beats that is coming up. And it's just such a solid game. Number 9, Hearthstone. Gotta put Hearthstone up there. Hearthstone has been a lot of fun to play. My only problems with Hearthstone, I think, are legendaries. Legendaries can be a little too ridiculous. And you can just craft a deck a little too well with legendaries. They just completely destroy people who don't have legendaries. And that's kind of the inherent flaw in TCGs anyway, is if you get all the good cards, like, you're gonna beat people who don't have all those cards. It's all about a race to getting all the cards you need to make an amazing deck. You can be great without legendaries, but I find legendaries a little too ridiculous. I will forever hate Ysera. If I ever get Ysera, that's going in every deck I have ever, because Ysera is a bastard. Definitely. But I really enjoy the game. It's really fun. In Hearthstone, you have so many close matches. It sucks when you have get run over, but I've had so many close matches in Hearthstone, it's always a treat to play. I just hate legendaries, I really do. And we'll see more LPs of Hearthstone in the future, because it's just too fun not to keep playing. Goblins and Gnomes has really brought me back into it. Now for number 8, and this is one that if you were at the 14-hour stream, you saw this one. That's Mario Kart 8. That was a lot of fun. Mario Kart 8 is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Very fun to play, especially with other people. We played 4-man Mario Kart, and it was incredibly fun. Oh my god, is this game fun. We got to do another stream with that. We had to jury-rig things a little bit to be able to show it on stream, but it is a lot of fun to play, and that's why it's up there. It's just awesome. Just awesome. But number 7 is Ziggurat. Ziggurat, in my opinion, is how you do a first-person roguelike. This is the best there is. It sets the standard, in my opinion. It is amazing. This game is a load of fun, and we, of course, have videos of Ziggurat. Well, one-shot video of Ziggurat. It's a lot of fun, and I've randomly played on stream as well. Fun game. Just an awesome game. And they keep adding more to it. This is a roguelike. It's a roguelike first-person shooter. You get random weapons. You have a choice of like 12 or 13 characters. There's about 26, 27 minions to fight, and there's about a dozen bosses to fight as well. And it's just such a big game, and they're adding more. They're adding more rooms to it, more enemies. They keep adding to the game, not even as DLC, but just to make the game better. This is an awesome game. This is an amazing game that more people should check out. It is very fun, and I hope you do. Number 6, Call of Juarez Gunslinger. This story was really good. Very well done in the voice work. Very well presented. It looks great. It plays very well. Just really fun. And this, it was just great. I really enjoyed this game. There's a lot of facts about the West as well in there if you're a big Western buff. And that was awesome. This was a fun game. I enjoyed a lot. And it deserves its place on this list. Number 6. Now coming up are Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. This is a game that is close to my heart. Monster Hunter is always a fun game. I played Tri when it was on Wii U. I played the original on PlayStation. I played... The only one I haven't played, I think, is 2. And the Japanese online one. I think it was the only ones I haven't played. I've played everything else. And this is very much a game where you're just this lone badass. It takes a while to build up and get to that point, but you're this lone hunter who fights these giant monsters, and it's just so fun. It is really great to play that game. I'd say if you want to get into Monster Hunter, wait for 4. Because 4 is going to be even better. I played it at Comic-Con. Oh my god, is it a great game. It was just awesome. Number 4 on the floor is Smash. And I'm counting both Smashes on this. I'm counting both of them, 3DS and Wii U, as one game. And they're just both very fun. Now, I'm sad there's no story mode, because I really like the story mode. It's fun seeing your characters interact with each other. It's kind of a fan fiction there. So it's too bad that's not in it. But there's a lot coming out of this game. Now, if you play the entire series, there's little improvements that have happened along the way. Little things have made Smash better and better and better. It's a lot of the same, but there's a lot more to it as well. It's evolved very well, and it's just a very fun game. There's a lot of modes to play, a lot of different ideas. I don't really care about the board game mode all that much, but I do like Master Orders, Crazy Orders, the Smash Run, and just playing the game straight up, doing the events. There's a lot of fun stuff going on with this game. It's just a great game, fun to play alone, fun to play with others, fun to play on the go. It is just fun on a bun. Oh yeah. Now before I announce the top 3, gotta do some honorable mentions. I gotta mention Child of Light. That is a good game to cure your insomnia. It is a sweet game, very fun. I'm glad Ubisoft actually tries to do these games like this. And they're gonna try to do another one because Child of Light made enough money. I don't really like Ubisoft, but I'm glad they're trying to do little games as well. And Child of Light was a good game, but it's such a storybooky kind of game and so gently made it makes you sleepy. So I actually haven't finished that game despite having it for almost like half a year. Nosgoth is a multiplayer only game. That was a lot of fun to play. Showed it off a bit. Gave away some keys for that. It's a fun game and I can't wait to see it come out of beta. Because I want to see how it can be improved. Matchmaking is the only thing that ruins it a little bit. You need people to have even levels. When a high level person fights with a low level person, it's just a runover. But it's pretty fun. Firefall, another free game. Firefall's pretty fun. It's basically just a horde mode game, though. I enjoyed it a lot, but I just didn't have the time to play it. It's a really good game, though. Contrast, we have a video. Oh, by the way, we have video of Child of Light one-shot, Nosgoth one-shot, Firefall one-shot. Contrast, we had a whole LP on that one. Contrast is a short game, very fun. I really enjoyed it. Just beautifully made. I wish there was more to it. Jinx feels like it was good in its small size, but there was something about it that I just wanted more out of it, and I can't wait to see if they make a sequel or just make another game kind of like that or something out of the indies that made that. It was just a good game there. We do have an LP of it. The Banner Saga. I won't share why the Banner Saga isn't in the top 20. It is a good game, but there is something about the game that kind of screws it up for me and just makes it not as great. And the thing that also bothers me is it's actually first of a trilogy, and you don't even know if they'll be able to afford to make 2 and 3, because indies, not just money, but they might come apart and stuff like that. But this is the first of a trilogy. Did not know that. That's kind of what ruins it a little bit, is because I didn't know it was the first of a trilogy. There's a lot going on, and you just are holding the ball waiting for 2. That's a bit frustrating that way, and that's kind of what brings it down. But it is a pretty fun strategy game. Not bad at all. Very well made. Beautiful. Really good music. Just, it hurts itself, unfortunately. Thief is another honorable mention. Thief, we did an LP on that. I had a lot of fun with it. It is a stealthy game, but you can be as horribly murdery as possible. And I was. I murdered everything. And I just had a lot of fun playing that. Invisible Ink is an early access game from people who made Don't Starve. And Invisible Ink's really good. They're balancing out pretty well. It's a very challenging grid-based game where you're these thieves, well, stealing things. And it's pretty fun. And the way it ramps up the difficulty as you go is pretty good. I just had a lot of fun with it, and I can't wait to play the full version. Risk of Rain. Now, this is a lot of fun. You can just sit down, play this roguelike platformer, just destroy everything. It's really fun to play a lot. And we'd have to do like a top 30 for this one to get in. It's just a lot of fun games we play. Risk of Rain's a fun game, but there's a lot of other fun games we play, which is why it isn't on the list. But then there is Alien Isolation, which I initially thought it'd get on the list, but it didn't because of the one problem it has. Alien Isolation has the best atmosphere I have ever experienced in a game. It does a great job. So good at it. What hurts it is the frustration it creates. This is the problem with it. I had to rage through that game. I had to rage through the frustration to finish that game. The alien was way too frustrating. Even when I hid a lot, I had to do a lot of hiding, did a lot of distracting the alien, but it just hung around for like 10, 20 minutes. Like, it just never left. Like, it stays still. Just stay still. Wait, and just circles around. There's small parts in the game where it's like that, where you're just sitting and waiting to do nothing while the alien just F's off. Those moments really ruin the game for me. When you're dealing with just humans, you're dealing with just the androids, or when they're all interacting at the same time, it's really cool that way. Well, there's just moments where it's just too frustrating. And I think when those moments happen, they need to just let you through in some way, but still make it feel right. Because it just, the frustration just really mars the game. It's an amazing game, but the frustration to it just did not make it good enough. And that's just too bad. It's good, but not good enough, because you have to find the balance, the pacing of difficulty. The story is paced pretty well. Like, there's a lot of games that suffer from some sort of pacing, and sometimes difficulty pacing is the problem. Inconsistent difficulty can really ruin a game, and it ruined Alien Isolation for me, which is just disappointing, because it is an amazing-looking game, and it just feels great. Another frustrating game, of course, is Dark Souls 2. And Dark Souls 2, again, just, it's fine to play it, but it was just too frustrating. Just really was too frustrating. Jinx told me that I actually was playing Dark Souls 2 on hard mode, by the way. I did not know that. And yeah, it was pretty hard. We finished it, though. We did pretty well, but I don't know. Like, my problem with Dark Souls games is that they're meant to be fun by frustrating you, and I don't know. I don't really like that at all. It was a fun game, enjoyed it, but there was too many moments where I'm just raging through the frustration to finish the game. And that's not a fun thing. And that kind of hurts it a bit. It's a great looking game, plays pretty well, but it spends too much time enjoying effing you off. And not a fan of that. So now the top three. Top three. All right. Number three, Wolfenstein. This I would call game of the year when it comes to first-person shooters. It had an amazing story. The characterization was great. Music was amazing. It just looked good. The weapons were fun to play with. Oh, once you get that special, like, laser thing, that was great. And, oh my god, Fergus is hard to beat. Fergus was probably best character of the year in any game. He was amazing. How can you beat that guy? That was great. Wolfenstein is number three. It was just really good. Game of the year, first-person shooter for me. Game of the year, narrative, probably. Game of the year in a lot of ways. Just really great direction of camera work. Just, it's a solid game. I did not expect this game to be that good. I thought it was just going to be have fun shooting things, But the story wowed me. It just did a great job. It was amazing. So what's number two? How about the craziest balls of the walls possible? Metal Gear Revengeance. That game was a lot of fun. Oh my god, was that game fun. Just sorting the ever-loving crap out of everything. Just chopping it up. Just running through and doing a lot of battles, fighting things. The only thing, of course, that hurt the game a bit was the bugs at the final boss. That is the one thing that kind of ruined that game, but it was just bugs. When the bugs weren't happening, the game was fine. But when those bugs happened, that final boss, it was not so great. But Jesus Christ, that game was amazing. So much fun to play that game. Then you got to play the DLCs, which were also fun. Just a great game. Of course, Wolfenstein and Metal Gear Revengeance, we did LPs on. So what's number one? I think it's kind of obvious, isn't it? Kind of obvious what number one is. Shadow of Mordor. That is number one. I had way too much fun destroying everything. I had too much fun murdering everyone. This was a very cathartic, the right word? I don't know. It is just really fun destroying Uruks. Way too much fun. And it's just, even when the deaths, like some of the deaths were kind of ridiculous, or just some of the situations were just, oh my god, another captain. There were so many highlights from this game. So many amazing moments that we didn't even try to do, right? Like, they were just great. Like the Grog that hit me with a rock out of nowhere. That was awesome. I turn around, see a rock, boom. That was amazing. The characters were just great. There are things here and there. Some characters were great, some characters weren't so much, but the game itself was just too fun. The Nemesis system alone made this game amazing. That Nemesis system, just being able to just have all these different things that are special and strengths and weaknesses about each character, how they interact with you, the conversations they had with you. Very cool how you deal with your enemies. Very fun in that way. And then when we get through halfway point, we can control them? We can make them do things? The game just got even better at the halfway point. The first half of it was so fun, so sandboxy, just running around, just having fun wrecking things. And then you tell me we can wreck it even more, and we can set up wreckage? Oh my god! It was fun! So fun! I can't wait for the DLCs to come out, so we can do the LP on that. It was just the best. Oh my god, just great LPs out of the top three. We have LP video of Wolfenstein, LP video of Metal Gear Vengeance, and LP video of Shadow of Mordor. All three were fun to play. All three were just amazing. There is no way around it. They were just great games to play. My god, were they fun. And I can't wait to play more in the future. And that's the top 20. I did a lot of talking there. I hope Jinx... We went over on the arena. Hercules Arena was only 20 minutes. I tried to talk as fast as I could on this, but oh my god, there's only so much to say about all these games, and we made quite a list there. Honestly, I should have said at the start, hey, Dad, make some guesses of what the top 20 is, and honestly, I might still want to do that. I might still want to say, take some guesses, at the start of this video, or just tweet out, hey guys, take some guesses, or just say, actually, it's hard to take guesses, because you guys didn't see me play some of these games, like Monster Hunter and Smash and Mario Kart. The Nintendo games, you guys didn't see me play them, so it's harder to make those guesses. Maybe I should just say the top three guesses. If anyone gets those right, but it was a fun year, and next year is gonna be a lot of fun too. I am very happy with where we are and proud of what we've done. You just look at the videos, like look at the old stuff, look at the videos now, you can see our evolution pretty well. You can see how far I've come as far as entertainment goes. You can see where Jinx has come with all of her editing work. It is amazing what she's been doing. Those big texts are great, her highlight work is great. She's just gotten really good at this. And this is when she had, when we started, she had zero knowledge. When I started, I had zero knowledge. We didn't know what we were doing. We've been figuring out as we go. I've been figuring out how to better present things and say things and stuff like that. And she's been figuring out all the editing and presentation, all that stuff. I do the guides myself. I had to figure that stuff out. We've learned a lot in 2 years. And we're going to learn a lot more and improve and do even better. Keep going. Make it even just a greater channel. We're almost at 5,000 subs this year. Next year, we're going to hope for 10,000 and 20,000. Just keep doubling up every year. Eventually, we'll hit a million in like 10 years. We'll do ScarfCon eventually. We'll do everything we plan to do. We will keep pushing for that. We're going to push to be the best because that's who we are. We always try and fight our hardest for what we want to do. That's just how we are and that's what we will do. And it's just a lot of fun. Been a lot of fun doing this. I am proud of it. I am proud of what we've done. And I'm happy to have made our viewers smile and laugh. And of course, most proud of the fact we've actually prevented some deaths. We've done that. Like, we've been told that by the people, that we've stopped that. That's huge. To be able to entertain people to the point that we prevented something as dark as that. And that really pushes true into my heart, because obviously I almost did that myself. That is a dark road to go, and I almost went to the full end of it, and some other people almost did as well, and we stopped that. That's huge. That makes everything we've done worth it. Any smile, any laugh makes it worth it, but doing that is huge. Very big. Makes it bigger than who we are. It makes everything bigger. It changes perspective and just makes us go, we're going to keep doing this. We got to keep doing this. It's just too fun to do, and it's pretty important. Even if it's only one or two lives, that's more than, well, not doing that. Any life is important after all, right? But it's been a hell of a year. Been a hell of a year. I'll be doing plenty of schooling. I'll eventually get a job and everything, and then I'll be more busy. But we'll be able to afford things. Like, we're able to afford things now thanks to the help of people on Patreon. That is just great. And eventually the help from that Patreon will allow us to eventually employ Jinx so she can do even more things full time. Right now she's got her freelance work and all that stuff, so she's not able to dedicate as much time as she could if she was full time. In the future, that would be the goal, is get Jinx full time and then me full time after her. Because I, like, what I'm doing, how am I gonna put this? Like, editing work is, it takes a lot of work. I do a lot of studying stuff, and I do a lot of reading, try to do more entertainment stuff like that. But that's stuff I can do reading while on the job. Jinx is doing the intensive editing work. She's doing the intensive making highlights, making videos. Like, she'll be drawing more assets. She'll be doing a lot of things at full time. These are all things that you can't do while having a job at the same time. The stuff I can do, I can study, I can practice my voicing, I can do all this stuff while working. I can do funny voices while working. Like, it'll confuse some people, it'll weird them out. But I can do that while working. You can't edit a video while working. Like, you can't do that. So, my side of things, I am able to have a job at the same time. Her side of things, she would need to make it full-time. So it's Jinx first, then me. That's the plan. At the same time, because I have this job, I'd be able to pay for more games or just do giveaways, stuff like that. We'd still have the Patreon going to support other things, but then I can use my money to support things as well. That's really the plan, is we have the Patreon money supporting the channel in some ways, and we'll have me supporting the channel in other ways. I also have a family to look after all, so I gotta watch out for them with some of my money, but I will put some of my money into the channel. I put some of my money into, like, giveaways. This is, like, I don't know if I've ever said this. I think I've said it once. What I want to do after I get a job is buy, like, indie games that I think are really good. Find one that I really like and go to the developer and go, hey, I want to buy 10 copies and I want to give them to my viewers so they can check out this game, have fun with it, and maybe they'll spread the word so that even more people might want to buy your game. That's something I want to do. But it requires seed money to do it first, and that seed money is me having a job. But it's something I want to do for the indie scene, is spread the word, and it doesn't cost them anything. It costs me money, and just see how it goes in that way. That's something I want to do. And then if we get bigger and better, like we're able to do it with bigger title names and stuff like that, we would do that. That's something I want to do. It's not giveaways for, like, here's the thing, this is the problem with giveaways is, and it's just inherent because people see the dark side to it, and that is people doing giveaways to get popular. And that's a thing that happens. People do that to get their numbers up. But that's not the reason why I want to do it. I want to do it because I want to introduce you guys and gals to more games to enjoy. To things you might not have thought of. That's what the one-shot's always been, is pointing out games like, hey, this is a lot of fun. Or sometimes I'll just do a triple and go, this was fun. Maybe you're on the fence on this triple A, I don't know. But the one-shot's always been to introduce you to something. And sometimes the LPs are to introduce you to something as well. Well, a lot of times LPs are to introduce you to something. They're always introducing to something new. We are quite eclectic in what we play. We play a lot of different things, and we show off a lot of different things in. But that's what I want to do, and the coming year I should be able to do it, is get the job, and then I can afford to give things away, so you guys can just check them out. And I think that's just great, because then you guys get to play more things. I think that'll just be awesome. That's, of course, me being optimistic. That's me being very optimistic, but I believe it's not something that is too, you know, ridiculous to do. I don't know what kind of darkness you can see that besides saying, oh, he's just trying to get views, or he's just trying to get viewers, that's it. But I don't like that, because I don't like being misunderstood in what I do, but I'll deal with it, I guess, because you guys are the ones that benefit from it. You guys get these free games to play, and you get to see if you like it, and you get to tell other people if you like it or not, which will benefit the indie developer. It's a grassroots way of getting them bigger, I guess. And I am bloating this thing, but it is the end of the year. This is the last vlog of the year, after all. And it might even come out the start of the next year. I'm not sure when this is coming out. But I have my intentions. I have what I want to do, and trust me, they're as pure as I can make them. It's at the end of the day, you can't please everyone, and you can't prove to everyone that you're not a bad guy. Someone's always gonna think you're some douche. That's just how it is. But I'd rather not be thought of as a douche. Like, I do what I do because I do what I do. Like, my opinions are my opinions. What I do is what I do. That's, I don't know any way to put it. I don't want to be thought of as an asshole for what I think, but at the end of the day, someone's going to think you're an asshole no matter what you do. I'm worrying too much, aren't I? Yeah, I am. But in the future, things are coming up. Things are coming out because I really enjoy this channel. I know Jinx does as well. I just really like enjoying it, entertaining everyone. It's too fun to not do that. It's just fun entertaining people. It's fun writing scripts to do things, having fun trying to get better at being entertaining. It's just too fun. And I find there's great meaning to it. But that right there is gotta be the vlog. We're already at 40 minutes. It's been a great year. I'm really proud of what we've done, and I'm proud of my viewers. We have pretty good viewers. And we have really good viewers. I like my viewers. I like them a lot. You guys have your opinions. I don't always agree with y'all, and I try not to browbeat too much, but I will browbeat Mist at least. Swear to God, Mist, and I think Haim, you guys have opinions that are so opposed to mine every single time. I go, God damn it, I hate you guys, but I love you guys as well. I love my viewers. I love them a lot. Thank you to everyone who's donated. Sober Sniper, Was It My Ninjas, Wiso, Mist has donated. I think Haim's donated as well. Crap. I'm going to leave out names, and I don't mean to. Chin, Kowak. Oh, God, there's so many names. Lactastic Cow's been fun. Dr. Snorlax. Moo Cow. Ah, I can't remember your full name right now. There's a cow. Can't remember your full name. Of course, Dave. Dave has been awesome. Camel Spider Dave, and people we've lost over the year. Too bad we don't have them anymore, but thank you to them for being around. Thank you to everyone. And there's so many names I'm not thinking of right now on the spot that you guys have been awesome. You guys have been awesome. Of course, Koek's been a dork the whole year, but that's Koek being Koek. But it's just been great. It has been great playing these games with y'all or showing them to y'all and interacting with everybody. And I gotta mention Jamere. J-A or J-E-M-E-R-E. He's got like a Cartman icon. That dude's been around for 2 years. That is, I can't think of anyone older than him besides maybe Double Hammer. They've been around that long. That is awesome. Oh, of course, Blue Turtle. Thank you to Blue Turtle for being around. If I don't remember your name, my apologies. There's so many people. Spaceman, Ninjax is always there. Ninjax is always there. Ninjax is always at the streams. So many names. I don't want to forget anybody, but I am forgetting names right now. There's just, we've had so many awesome people, and I just want this list to go on and on and on. Someday I have to say 100 names or just whatever. Just, I am so optimistic. I know I get pessimistic because it's mine sometimes, but I'm just so optimistic about everything. It's just so fun. It's just great to do, and we're going to always do it. And as long as you guys and gals are getting entertained, that's all that matters. That's all that really matters. There's enough bad stuff in the world to think about and deal with. Let's have fun once in a while, right? And this is us doing that. Giving people something to have fun and enjoy and hopefully look forward to. God dang, this was a long vlog though. Oh man. Oh, I'm gonna pay for this one. I'm gonna pay for this one. But that right there, that's the vlog. A bit of a mess, right? But thank you to everyone. Thank you in general. I'm always thankful. I must always be thankful. Because it's important to be thankful. It just is. But that's everything. Thank you to Jinx for all her hard work. Thank you to myself. Trying to do the best I can. Thank you as always. Thank you, and thank you. And I will see y'all whatever next video you see, and of course in the next year. And let's just hammer it out, right? I got a lot of hard studies to do, but I'm also going to be hitting the channel as hard as ever. Yeah, should be a lot of fun. And Smancers will be back eventually, and Gods will be back. Just, you know, holidays. But, I think that's everything. Love each and every one of y'all, even if I hate you. vlog over. That is the vlog. I've had fun watching and listening, and that's just all about, isn't it? Having fun. Thanks for coming by. And see you next time. Of course, you can say what you thought were your favorite games. You don't have to necessarily disagree with my list, but just say what you enjoyed this year. There's just so many awesome games every year to play. I love being in gaming. It's just so fun. Have fun, everybody.